Sunday when we have the honor and the joy of having American Ford Fire with us. Thank you so much for coming to the service and bringing so much beauty to our time together. On this wonderful Sunday, we'll also hear a reflection from EvanCorn, a member of our congregation who has a long relationship with American Ford Fire.
Good morning. About 6 years ago, I started fourth grade at the American Boy Choir School. This was the turning point in my childhood life from a both musical aspect and an overall perspective. Though the experience was incomparable to any other, the choice to go did take some lengthy discussions with my two incredibly supportive parents. At that age, it was about what video game you just beat, not what song you could pick up and sing. So the choice was easy for me to make, to not go. Well, that's obviously not what happened. And since today's service is the question box theme, I thought I'd give ninth grade Evan, that's me, a chance to answer some of fourth grade Evan, that was me, questions, honestly. So let's get started. Hello, little Evan. Hi. Here's my first question, which is really three questions in one. What if I don't want to wear uniforms rehearsed for 2 hours a day and stay at school until 6 o'clock? These were by far my lamest questions I asked myself and my parents. To me, the thought of wearing uniforms was, and I quote, unfair and ridiculous. How could anybody be okay with wearing a uniform for 10 hours a day? It was absurd. Sorry, little Evan, you are wrong. In fact, wearing a uniform made my tired mornings much easier as it wiped out the idea of having to pick out the coolest outfit each day. Don't worry, little Evan, this uniform thing isn't the cause of your downfall. That happens later. At least I assume it does, because it hasn't happened yet. Going until 6 o'clock was by far the idea that angered me the most. At my then current school, I was out by 3, chilling at after school and outside on the playground, where the real stuff happened. 6 o'clock bothered me because it was so late in the day and I would not have time to play outside when I got home. Well, you know what, little Evan? Get used to it. That's how it's going to be in the real world, so you might as well start early. As for the rehearsal thing, even as I progressed through my career at ABS, that time I still didn't feel like going. But I went, and eventually something happened. Rehearsals actually started to be enjoyable. Crazy, right? I think it was a combination of what I had learned about music and how much I had grown in character over the past years. Question two, what if I don't want to go away on tours? This question was a little more understandable as I was only 9 years old. Tours were usually, at that time, 20 to 25 days long. And as I moved into my fifth grade year, my first year in concert choir, or the upper choir, which we have today, I decided to pass on my first tour. My reason was I'd rather stay home and play video games. Looking back, I can't believe I gave that as a reason to not go on tour. But that's what I told my parents, and it made a lot of sense to me then. The first tour I eventually went on, the one directly after the one I missed because of my devotion to video games, was kind of a nightmare, but at the same time an eye-opening experience. The reason it was a nightmare for me was because I absolutely hated being away from home. Thankfully, it was only December tour, which as all ABS boys know, is the shortest tour but filled with the most work. Lucky for me, I was blessed with my next tour, which was, that's right, only 32 days long. Wow, felt like 50. It was a rough 4.5 weeks. Did I mention on that particular tour, we had to do a music festival, and rehearse with other choirs for 8 full hours a day for 3 days in a row? Through the years after that, my tours went pretty well. I got to go to France and Korea and sing with the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. That was pretty awesome. So my answer for you, little Evan, is, say that you don't want to go on tours now, but when they come, enjoy it, because once they're gone, they are, well, gone. Question three, will I make any friends? I have the answer already. I wish so much that my eighth grade classmates were here with me right now, giving their own speeches. Sadly for me, many of them are away in school at schools in Connecticut, New Hampshire, Washington, D.C., Australia, Florida, and South Carolina. Luckily, though, some are close by at Lawrenceville, Hopewell, and Pennington. I had a thought occur to me a couple months back, and it keeps returning to my mind. That is, I will never be in a room with those same people ever again. I so incredibly hope I can prove this false in the near future. Maybe it'll happen at this year's Christmas concert. By the way, buy tickets. But who knows? So there you go, 11. That's about it. Did I answer all your questions? Probably not. Little 11 had no idea what was going to happen back then. But now, I can truly say that the American Boy Choir School has changed me so much, and for the better, I might add. I hold doors for people 20 feet back. I know solfege back and front and can name any key signature, mode, and time signature of any song you hand me. Now that I'm not petty, I realize how much ABS has taught me and how much of what I learned at ABS continues to help me. Don't get me wrong, I have also learned a lot in the time that I've been at Petty, except for the music part, of course. But let me tell you guys now, when you move on to high school, wherever you go after ABS, you will fall asleep in chorus if you choose to do chorus. It has happened to me many a time, and it's only November. ABS is so good at preparing you for life and what it will throw at you. They are excellent at what they teach you, us in music too. You need to appreciate it now. Even though I can still sight read, sadly enough, I'm losing what I learned. They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a specific topic or subject. My 5 years at ABS and all the other musical experiences I've had, and continue to have, I'm getting close to that number. I wish that the music experience that happened at ABS was still in my daily routine. Wow, little 11, can you believe I'm saying that? By the time my high school choir had picked up 4 songs, I knew that you guys had already picked up 10 to 15. I'm really not trying to brag about myself in ABS. I'm just saying what an incredible experience you guys are getting. Cherish it. And this is for you, 8th graders. I know tomorrow you'll be talking about what teacher did what annoying thing and how boring class and rehearsal sometimes are. Trust me, I know. I did it for 5 years, and some of you will have too. But think about all the positive pieces and parts of ABS you have now, because again, once it's gone, it's gone. Thank you, and good luck. And you know I have to say it, brothers, sing on.